Mr. President, I just wanted to take a moment to express concerns that I have about the efforts underway here to repeal the personal property tax on manufacturing machinery, equipment, and inventory. I've done a little bit of research, and I see that a lot of states have some form of inventory or machinery and equipment taxes, but some states who once had those taxes have gotten rid of them. One state that falls into that category is the state of Ohio. Ohio eliminated their business personal property tax, and as a result, according to a peer-reviewed study, they lost thousands of jobs. The numbers are maybe close to 20,000 jobs that were lost as a result of the elimination of that tax. And that might seem counterintuitive, but according to the research that's been done, that in the short term, repealing this kind of tax encourages investment in capital and in automation and not in people. And so the job growth actually went down in that state. And I'm afraid that in the short term, if we were to repeal this tax, we would actually see the same kind of thing happen here in West Virginia. We would actually lose jobs, and we would be incentivizing companies to invest in capital and in automation and not in West Virginians. Here in West Virginia, this personal property tax that we're talking about is relied upon by counties pretty substantially. Some counties get more revenue than others. I'm obviously a little biased towards the northern part of the state, and we do a lot of the heavy lifting when it comes to the chemical industries, the steel industries, manufacturing industries, and we always have. If the personal property tax on manufacturing machinery, equipment, and inventory would be repealed, my counties would take a huge hit. Based upon numbers from 2018, Hancock County would lose $5.5 million in revenue each year. Marshall County would lose 5.3. Brook County would lose $6.2 million. Ohio County would also lose money in the process. Counties and cities and schools would all face serious impact if this tax were to be repealed. And not only am I worried about it, but my county commissioners are worried about it. They've contacted me about it. They've spoken about it publicly. My city officials are also concerned about it. They were here at the Capitol the other day expressing their concerns about their inability to pay for public safety, to pay for firefighters, to pay for their share of roads that they're responsible for in their communities. And so they're all worried about how this revenue is going to be replaced, and they've expressed those concerns to me. And although my district is made up of some really tough and really resilient people, and we've been through a lot of tough times, this would be a huge blow to the northern district, the northern part of this state up in the panhandle. We've had some big blows as of late. We had a hospital close in Wheeling. We had a hospital close right across the river that employed a lot of people from my district. And that was and is still being dealt with, and it was a huge blow to our area. We're facing other attacks on jobs and job providers in our community right now in this legislature. So what I'm concerned about is how we're going to replace that revenue. I looked at the numbers from WVU from their economic analysis, and in 2022, we have a projected budget deficit of $170 million. In 2023, it's $157 million. 2024, it's $171 million. And in 2025, it's $164 million projected budget deficit. So I just don't see how we're going to replace that revenue, and I'm nervous and concerned for the counties that would be impacted by this. And I also worry about future revenue that we might be sacrificing. I don't know how many of you know, but that plant in Doddridge County, the natural gas processing plant, generates revenue of $2.6 million every year based upon this tax that we're talking about repealing. That would go away if we were to go forward with this. And we've got big plans in Brook County and Hancock County to develop more in the manufacturing industries. Again, another thing I'm talking to my county commissioners about. And I'd be worried about future revenue that would also be sacrificed if we would go forward with something like this. So I guess in the end, my point, Mr. President, is until I can see how my counties will be made whole, I'm going to have a hard time getting behind something like this. And looking at the numbers, I would expect that my colleagues from Kanawha and Cabell, Wood, Monongalia, Putnam, Jackson, and Berkeley would feel the same way, because they're also going to take a pretty big hit if this were to happen. Thank you very much.